Namaste everyone and welcome to Data Millennials.
Hello everyone, welcome to our SQL series. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you where you can write your SQL queries. In big corporate houses or in any company, people prefer whatever editor is provided by their organization. But for you guys, I have chosen Microsoft Workbench because I personally feel it's very helpful editor at the beginning stage and I'm using it since my college time. So I have a very soft corner for SQL Workbench. So the first question comes that where will you find this editor, right? Now, to help you with that, I am showing you this link, this dev.mysql.com/downloads/workbench. So I have opened this page where we can get this software by simply choosing the right option, which is your correct operating system. By the way, you can find this URL also in the description below. So after choosing the right option, so when I'm saying option, you need to go to this select operating system, and based on your operating system, you need to select the right options first. So for example, mine is Windows, so I'll choose Microsoft Windows and then I'll click on download. But in my case, I have already downloaded it and I'm using it for a very long time. So you just need to select your operating system here and then click on download. So once your software download is completed, you guys need to install this editor by following the given instruction during the installation process. So as I have already downloaded and installed this editor, so let's go and start with the introductory part. But before we start, let me open the editor from the start menu. Right, so how we can do it? We have to go to start menu and then I need to type workbench. So once your software will be installed, this workbench will be installed, you will be able to find it in your start menu. In your start menu, you just need to type workbench and you will see this app. Click on it and the application will appear on your screen. Right? As you can see, Workbench is open now, but hey, this is not the editor, right? Actually, this is the main program. Workbench works on the client server architecture. To access the editor, you need to create a root password and then log in into the editor. So what you need to do is that by default, you will have this local instance MySQL80. You need to click on it and then configure it. So you can see here, the root is my ID, and based on your preference, you can put the password. Right, and you will be using this local instance my80sql to run your SQL queries, and this is the place where you will write your queries. So if I click on it, it will start opening the editor part. Okay, so it has opened the editor. As you can see, I have written multiple queries here, right? This is the part where you write query, and this is the below, which you can see this is output, where output is written. This is the place where your output will be reflected. Now, how we can create a new, or how we can create a new file where we can write our queries? To create a new file, you have options here. This option, create a new SQL tab for executing queries, right? Or you can go to file and then you can create. After going on file, you can click on new query tab. So you will see this. Sorry, you will see this. The new query tab has been opened, right? Now, this is the place in extreme left side under navigator. You will see these are the schemas. When I say schemas, you will see your database and your tables here. So for example, if I click on this email data, you will see this table, right? It has multiple options: table, views, stored procedures and functions. So what is this email data? Email data is a database which I had created earlier. Now within this email database, I had multiple tables. So you can see that there are multiple tables here. Within a single database, you can store multiple tables. And if you had created some view, you will be able to click on views and all the views will be reflected in front of you. Same it goes with stored procedure and functions. Now we'll go through this, all these options, once we will start running our queries, and I'll show you in detail about it. So once you have written some query in it, for example, if I write a simple query, select a star from table name, this means that I am selecting everything from a particular table which whose name is name, or I'll put it as TB. So TB is my table, for example, and I'm selecting everything from a table named as TB, and now I need to save this query. How can I do it? It's a simple thing. Either you can press Ctrl S, have your Windows Explorer open where you can save your query. If you want to save somewhere else, then you can select options here and save it there. Now if you want to open a particular query which has been already saved on your system, then what you need to do is that you need to go on File, then you need to click Open SQL Script. It will again open your Windows Explorer where you can navigate through your query where your query is saved, and then you can open it. So we have reached at the end of this video. In our next video, I'll give you a brief description about the data types of SQL.
Hey, if you find this video insightful, then do check out other videos and hit the like and subscribe button.